Hello, everyone, and welcome to this edition of Race Face Driver Updates. I'm Brittany Lung. Let's start by checking in with our Race Face drivers. Jesse Love had four nights of racing in a row, starting on the West Coast for two nights of racing in the Platinum Cup at Silver Dollar Speedway in his 5H Harley Van Dyke Wing Sprint car. On day one, Jesse qualified 15th out of 45 cars, finished 8th in his heat, and a 7th in the B main, but did not transfer to the A main. On night two, Jesse qualified 10th, ran 4th in his heat, transferring directly into the A main, where he finished 13th. Jesse then caught a flight to Jacksonville Speedway for the Power I National Midget Series, where he won his heat race and finished 7th in the A main on Friday. We have one more night left. That was at Spoon River Speedway in Lewiston, Illinois. Jesse was 11th in hot laps, finished 2nd in the B main, and brought home a 7th in the A main after starting 18th. Up next for Jesse, back to Jacksonville Speedway this weekend. Joe Valento was at Marshfield Motor Speedway for the second time this year in his Midwest Truck Series Nitro Lubricant Ardent Mill Chevrolet. Joe qualified 2nd, missing the pole by 18/1000ths of a second. Joe finished 2nd in his heat race and started P2 for the feature. Joe was hunting down the leader when he got spun by another competitor and had to restart at the tail end of the field, but raced his way back to a 5th place finish. Up next for Joe this Saturday night at Jefferson Speedway, where they are making up a race that was rained out earlier this year. Connor Mosack was at Hickory Motor Speedway for twin 40-lap features in his number 18 Nick Taylor late model. In race one, Connor finished 4th and then brought home a 2nd place finish in the 2nd 40-lap feature. Up next for Connor, back at Hickory on September 14th. Now let's check in on the Race Face Next drivers. Cassidy Hines was back in her wingless Friends of Jacqueline 600 Micro Sprint on Saturday at I-76 Speedway in Fort Morgan, Colorado, where she finished 5th in her heat race, then brought home a top 10 and 7th in the A-Main. Up next for Cassidy, Micro Sprints at El Paso County Raceway on September 14th. Kobe Sokol was also at I-76 Speedway for the Micro Sprint Series. Colby started 3rd in his heat race and then parked his number 24S in victory lane. In the feature, he had to start 6th due to the invert. He battled a slick racetrack trying to find some grip, but had to settle for a 4th place finish. Up next for Colby, El Paso County Raceway on September 14th. Justice Sokol took his restricted 600 micro sprint and raced with the non-restricted sprints again this weekend at I-76 Speedway. The lawman finished 2nd in his heat race, then brought home another top 10 and 9th in the A-Main. Up next for Justice, El Paso County Raceway on Saturday. Jake Bowman was at Kern County Raceway Park in his INEX Legend car, where they combine all 4 classes into one race on Saturday. Jake had to start at the back of the pack, but raced hard and won the Young Lions division and placed 2nd overall in the A-Main. Up next for Jake, back in the Legend car at Irwindale Speedway on Saturday. William Cox is pulling double duty this weekend in his INEX Legend car, first at Anderson Speedway on Friday competing in the Young Lions division, where he brought home a 3rd place finish in the A-Main. On Saturday, Will headed to Charlotte Motor Speedway in the very tough 1/5 mile track for the first time, where Will brought home another top 5 finish in 4th place. Up next for Will, back to Anderson Speedway on Friday night. Grant Thompson was at Mobile International Speedway with a chance to win the 2019 track championship in the Pro Truck Series. Grant entered the race with a slim 12-point lead. He qualified 2nd and started 3rd. The race strategy was to stay out of trouble and finish inside the top 3, and that's exactly what he did, finishing in 3rd and winning his first Pro Truck Championship. Congratulations, Grant. The last 30 days have been quite exciting for the young Mobile, Alabama racer. Up next for Grant, he will be testing at Madeira Speedway for his upcoming October 5th Junior Late Model race on Thursday. Race Face drivers that were not racing this past weekend but will compete this weekend include Anthony Alfredo, who will be at Las Vegas Motor Speedway for the NASCAR Gander Outdoor Truck Series. Sheldon Creed will also see action in the truck race at Las Vegas on Friday. Sam Mayer will be back in the ARCA Racing Series at Salem Speedway on Saturday. Brian Henderson will be competing at Laguna Seca Raceway in the IMSA Michelin Pilot Challenge on Saturday. Joey East will be back at Madeira Speedway in his open wheel focus midget. Bryce Bezanson will be at Evergreen Speedway in the NASCAR Whelen All-American Series on Saturday. That's it for this week's Race Face Driver Updates. And remember, if you miss any of our shows, you can get caught up on raceface.tv on demand. Don't miss Race Face Spotlight on Thursdays at 10 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, this week featuring Junior Late Model Challenge Camp winner Grant Thompson. As always, we encourage you to support local racing in your communities. Don't forget to follow us on social media. We'll be back next week with more from your favorite Race Face drivers. So get out there, have a great race week. I'm Brittany Lung. Thanks for watching.